Can you create an entire YouTube video using AI? Well, you can, but you probably shouldn't. What you should do is speed up tedious tasks by a lot by using AI correctly. In this video, I will show you 7 AI tools that you can start using now to make your marketing team 10 times more productive and still create original content. Hello, welcome to the tubics YouTube channel. I'm Jan Fassbender from So Geht YouTube, and today we will take a look at the entire production process. Ideation, script writing, filming, editing, thumbnails, and how to get more out of one piece of content. I've got you covered. And of course, all the links to the tools can be found in the video description below. Before we will take a look into more specialized tools, let's start and take a look at ChatGPT, a tool we probably all know and are familiar with. I find it particularly useful in situations where I don't really know what the next step is. I have just no idea and I need to get just some creative juices flowing. Let's take a look at some examples. First of all, you can use it for ideation for your YouTube videos. You could use a prompt like this. What are ideas for, put in an adjective, YouTube videos on your topics, perhaps on subtopics? This is pretty basic. If you want to get more out of it, more creative ideas, maybe even new ideas that are not on the how-to format you're used to, for example, you could use a prompt like this. Write a list of some creative format ideas that a YouTube channel on topic could create. It can also be great for your writing process. For example, if you're looking for examples, you could do, give me X examples on your topic. But you can also use it later in the process, not only ideation for your YouTube video topics or your script, but also ideation for your editing, for your thumbnails and so on. What might an ideal visual thumbnail for this YouTube video look like? Give me 3 examples. Create a video editing plan for this video. To do this, divide the video into sections and create a table with each section, the original content and appropriate recommendations for B-roll or animations. While this is all great for brainstorming and ideation, we need to keep 2 things in mind. First of all, it will give you pretty standard answers if you don't exactly know what you're looking for. This can be great in some cases as the answers are pretty relatable and might fit a big audience. But it cannot come up with highly creative new concepts as it can only give you what it already knows. It will always be a mix of something that already exists. The second thing you should definitely keep in mind is that it does not check anything. It will just guess. You know how it sometimes just makes things up and tells you that they were true, even if they are not? So don't use it for script writing if you don't feed it the right information beforehand. In my experience, it also doesn't know the ideal structure of a YouTube video if you don't tell it the structure you want. And it also doesn't know what search terms are searched more or less on YouTube. So the ideas are always just ideas and you need to validate them. So let's take a look at a tool that might be able to help us in these regards. With tubics, you can research keywords and get insights into the traffic and the competition. This uses real data from YouTube. So other than ChatGPT, you can rely on the results. And then the real AI magic of this tool starts. You can use it to write AI titles and video scripts based on industry insights and optimized for search and discovery. Let's take a look at how AI scripting works with this tool. After you found your keyword, you can create an outline using AI. This outline is optimized for what is recommended for YouTube videos. Afterwards, you can generate each individual content block. For AI titles and descriptions, you need to select a video and a target keyword for this video. Afterwards, the AI will create suggestions. After some waiting, you will have a title and description that is optimized on keywords. So this description will have the keywords for SEO and still fits the content of the video. It will also suggest chapters for your video and will insert the links from your channel automatically. All right, so we found our topic. We've written our video, we shot our video, and now let's look at video editing. And the first tool I want to look at is called Descript. The first step of video editing, if you used a script like we did in this example, is usually to edit out silences and bad tags. Wouldn't it be great if AI could do this automatically? Well, it can, and this is what the script Descript is for. First of all, the tool will transcribe your video and then you can edit it like you would in Microsoft Word, for example. So you can edit the video as text and it can automatically find silences, find repetitions and edit them out. Then you notice, damn, there's one little mistake in an otherwise perfect take. We need to reshoot the whole thing. Well, fortunately you don't, because Descript has another trick up its sleeve, voice cloning. you can create an AI model from any English-speaking voice. Then just change out the word in the script and it will create the audio as if it was spoken by the original speaker. Voila! Your take is saved, no reshoots necessary. Apart from editing, you might be interested in optimizing the video itself as well. For this, I would recommend RunwayLM. They have a lot of different tools. For example, you can create images and videos with it. You can erase things from videos. You can create slow motion out of videos with a normal frame rate. You can make images move. You can remove any background without the need of a green screen, and so on. Alternatively, take a look at CapCut. While their tools aren't as advanced as RunwayLM's, this is a video editing software that has all of these AI tools included. Optimizing the look of your video is all nice and good, but do you know what can really destroy your video? Bad audio. Just imagine you shot the whole thing just to notice that you shot with the wrong microphone or that there's a big and loud background noise throughout the whole thing. Adobe Enhance can help you to fix this. Just put in any audio clip, wait for a bit, and you will get out studio quality audio. At least that's what they promise. And in my experience, it actually works quite well. Another of Adobe's tools that can help you in the process is Adobe Photoshop. After they've included Adobe Firefly, their image creation AI, into Photoshop itself, you can just select any area that you want, put in your prompt, and get 3 examples of generations. This can be very helpful for thumbnails, and a great thing about it is that it's trained on Adobe's own stock photos and can be used commercially. Another use case for it can be set enlargements. I first saw that used by a musician who made a small room feel like an entire stage in his video. To do this, grab a frame of your original video, import it into Adobe Photoshop, and enlarge it using the AI tools. Put this image back in your video editing software and insert the original video. Great, so your video is done and published on YouTube. What about creating some more content from it automatically? Let me introduce you to Opus Clip and Submagic.co. These are 2 very similar tools that can help you to create shorts, reels, TikTok, whatever you want to use them for, out of your original long-form content. To do this, just put in your original long-form content and wait for a bit. The AI analyzes it and cuts it into new segments that you can use for shorts. These come already with subtitles, with emojis, and are also cut between different perspectives if you have multiple speakers. A quick side note, this works better for videos that are text heavy and doesn't really work if you have heavy visuals. And this is how to speed up your video editing process using AI. If you're a brand that wants to grow on YouTube, schedule a free consulting session with one of our YouTube experts, and we'll see each other in the next video. That's it from me. Bye, Yoyan.